of our nation find themselves in a quandary about their homes, they know that they can turn to Rob and Ning of Get Real. Rob and Ning then in turn share these stories so we can learn from them. Get some valuable real estate information and advice on the house, courtesy of Get Real.
Hello, Canation. It's Robin Ning. Ning, we're doing another episode of Quinton Get Real, and that's where we have a story of one of our clients who prefers not to go on TV,
right.
But the story is one that we should share with Canation.
Ito pong magkapatid, nakatira po sila sa isang property. Yung pong kapatid na isa ay nag-asawa na, and then ito pong isang kapatid is still single. And he is nearly retiring. Maybe another five, six years he will be retired.
Right.
So yun pong kapatid wants to move out because he's starting their business. And therefore, yun pong bahay merong equity, and so everything will be split up between them.
So really, you know, there's a couple of options. One option, which I think you're going to share, is selling the property.
Right.
And then I'll share with, you know, how to keep the property, right? So a couple of things. One is, he's there by himself and his little dogs, but he could certainly lease out, and he lives in a high rent area, lease out one of the master suites and recapture some of the money that his brother was putting towards expenses.
Okay.
He has a first loan, which is a great loan. It was done back when rates were about 3.6, and it's at a point where the first could be used, you know, to allow for the equity to do a reverse in about 5 or 6 years when he turns 62. The problem is he has to buy out his brother.
Right.
So he could get a HELOC, right? Take care of his brother, and obviously you get an appraisal, you account for closing costs, and you get the, you know, the value that would be his brother's, right?
Right.
If he wanted to get rid of the HELOC and get back to his first, he could always take a loan against his 401k, get that off title, go do his reverse, and then he would be able to repay his 401k with no payment on the reverse when he retired.
Right. Yeah.
So there is a way to keep the property.
Yeah. And there is another option. But the other option is to downsize. So meaning, ibibenta po niya yung property and bring all his equity into a house. Maybe that will be 20% down payment. By the time po siguro na mag-retire siya, he can convert that into reverse mortgage by putting only 20% down payment. Kasi by doing that po, he will be paying yung principal. So ibig sabihin, every month bumababa yung principal ng property, and hopefully nag-appreciate yung property. And so by that time, he can refinance it and don't put any more money and convert that into reverse mortgage. Yeah. Let me just explain po really quick kung ano yung reverse mortgage. Ang reverse mortgage po is an FHA loan. Na meron po tayong option, you can refinance through reverse or you can buy through reverse. Meron po tayong option to pay principal and interest or interest only, or no payment at all every month. All you have to do is taxes, insurance. That's all. That's all you have to pay. Kayo po yung nasa title, at yung inyo pong mga tagapagmana can still inherit the property when the retiree passes.
And in the case of our client, you know, he's stressed, but he's very fortunate in many respects, but he's very stressed. Has a lot of options.
Yes.
Glad he called us, and I think we'll help him. And so, you know, these are the things we do for Canation.
Right.
So Canation, if you have an issue, you need some planning, you need some sound, you know, support and some ideas, give us a call at 888-860-9530 or visit us online.
Or you can go to our website po and schedule yourself for a free consultation with either Robert or Ning.
That's correct. So Canation, from Robin Ning, until next time,
bye.